Hi kids, in this session you are going to learn about the education development of independent India. After the independence, what was the education system it was followed in India? That only you are going to see in this one. Okay, you are going to learn in this one. It brought a new hope, a new vision, a new future for the Indians. Actually, in 1948, Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission, it was appointed. Okay, in 1948, Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission. I hope that you know about the Dr. Radhakrishnan. His birthday only we are celebrating as a Teacher's Day. Okay. Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission was appointed to present a report on university education. In pursuance of the Commission's recommendation, University Grants Commission was constituted to determine the standard of higher education. One of the most important events that have taken place in the field of secondary education was the appointment of Secondary Education Commission in 1952 to 1953. Secondary education, actually, before that only they had the, after the 10th standard college, like that means a university only they will move on. But in 1952 to 1953, in that only they introduced the 10 plus 2 plus 3. That system they introduced. That means the Secondary Education Commission, it was set up in the 1952 to 53, and they started for the secondary education also. It only suggested the new organization patterns, improvement in the quality of textbooks, curriculum and methods of teachings. An education commission under the chairmanship of the Dr. S.D.S. Kothari, that was appointed by the Government of India in 1964, which embassies, that means the Kothari Commission, it is called as a Kothari Commission, which embassies the free and compulsory education, primary education for the children up to the age 14 years. And also the educational structure, it was changed as a 10 plus 2 plus 3. Okay, pattern were the recommendations of the Dr. D.S. Kothari Commission alone. National Policy on Education. What was the National Education Policy? It was introduced. Actually, first the National Education Policy, it was introduced in the 1968. In that one, the education, it actually, post-independent India, what are the education? It was there, everything only, it also contained there. And also, it aimed to promote the national progress, a sense of common citizenship and culture, and to strengthen national integration, that 1968 policy. After that, 1986, the Government of India introduced a new education policy. The aim of new education policy was to transform a static society into a vibrant one with a commitment to development as well as the change. For the development as well as the change, it should be there for the, in the education, it should be there. It embraced on the equal opportunities for marginalized sections of the country, and the removal of disparity through scholarships, adult education and open universities, especially in the rural India. Rural means village side India. Okay. The new education policy called for a child-centered approach in primary education. The new education policy, that means in the 1986, the new education policy which came there, it is called as a child-centered approach in the primary education. And also it launched the Operation Blackboard. It launched the Operation Blackboard. For what purpose they launched the Operation Blackboard means to improve the primary schools nationwide. Nationwide to improve the primary schools. And the new education policy, same with 1986 policy, it was revised in 1986 policy alone, it was revised in the 1992. And it investigated the formulation of a national curriculum framework, emphasis on in-service education, improvement of facilities and streaming of the evaluation system at the secondary stage. At present, in the 2019, again the new education policy, it came there, that means they started there, and it came into force from April 2020. In this one, actually what the pattern they followed, 10 plus 2 plus 3, this pattern only up to now we are following. But it is changed into 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. In that pattern only, it changed in the new education policy of the 2019. But actually, in the 2019 itself, they formed that one, but it came into force from April 2020. Okay, next we are going to learn about the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, already I said, isn't it? Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, it actually came into, that means it launched in 2002-2001. It introduced the universal elementary education. Actually, to achieve the universal elementary education alone, it was introduced as a Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. In the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, the primary vehicle for implementing the provisions of the right of children of free and compulsory education. Right of children to the free and compulsory education. For that person alone, that for that purpose alone, the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, it was started. Okay. It only, actually it started for the universal elementary education. And in that one, they introduced the RTE Act in 2009. That is a right for the right to the children for the free and compulsory education up to the age of 6 to 14 years. Okay, actually it came into force from the April 2010. In this one RTE Act, we are saying that right to the education for the free and compulsory education for the children, isn't it? In that one, what they did, the children in which school they want, they may learn. That only they insisted in that one. Some other activities, what are the activities they included in this one? Midday meals and stipend for the students and setting up of the school management committees and also teaching learning materials for the classrooms. If these are all the things, it was introduced only in the government schools, not in the private schools. But through the RTE Act, what they did, in which school the students, the children, they want to learn in the private school also, they may learn through the RTE Act. Next, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, RMSA, it is shortly known as RMSA. This also universalization of assess and improvement of the quality education in the secondary stage. Actually, this one, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, only the elementary education, okay, elementary level alone. But the Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, it was introduced for the secondary level education, to improve the secondary level education. And actually, it was implemented during the 11th five-year plan. The goal of RMSA to make secondary education in the qualitative, available, accessible and affordable to all young children from the age of 15 to 60 years. Science lab, library, in-service training for teachers, computer-aided education, co-curricular activities and teaching learning aids also provided by the Government of India through the Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan. In this scheme alone, in all the school level, they provided all these things. In the Union Budget of 2018-19 also proposed to give school education holistically without segmentation from preschool to class 12. Samagraha Shiksha, and to be prepared with the broadened goal of improving school effectiveness measured in terms of equal opportunities and also equal learning outcomes. It subsumes and schemes SSA and RMSA. In 2017, a committee was constituted by the Ministry of Human Resource Development to draft the National Education Policy. That only I said in the last session itself I told, isn't it? In the National Education Policy 2019, the report, it was submitted. It came into force from the April 2020. Next, we will move on to the educational development in the Tamil Nadu. Educational developments in Tamil Nadu. Actually, in the Asian times, in Tamil Nadu, the school was called as a Palli and the teacher was called as a Kanakkaiyar. Okay. The significant development took place in the field of education during only the Pallava period. The Pallava king supported the educational institutions through the endowments. The Vaishnava and Saiva mats also provided the boarding as well as the lodging facilities to all children as well as the teachers. From the Yuan Swang also we may know about the how the learning it was in the Kanchi. That means in the Kanchi, the Buddhist center was there. In that place, how the learning it was there. And the Chola period also most brilliant as and creative period in the Tamil literature. the Tamil education, it enjoyed the great connection with religion as well as the temple. Free education was given to all the peoples. The curriculum and syllabi had their theoretical background. From the inscription of that period, we can now gain knowledge about the qualification of teacher, method of teaching, salary of teachers, food provided to the students, and the land given to the schools. Everything we may learn from that one. Rajaraja Chaturveda Lingam, he was the famous seat of a Vedic college. At Tiruboni Vedic College also, it was very famous in the Pondicherry. Okay, the Chaturveda Lingam, I told, isn't it? In that one, Ennayiram, it is in the Ennayiram in former South Arcot district. We may check that one. The Tiruvadakkala inscription mentions the library, and Tiruvadudurai inscription of Veera Rajendra refers to medical schools. That means for the medical also, they kept so many schools during that period. The Pandya kings also patterned the Sanskrit, everything. Okay, actually first it was started by the Pallava king, and after the Cholas period and during the Pandya period, in all the periods the education, it was flourished alone. Land, it was given to the teachers, those who are teaching in the schools. For the teachers, they gave the free lands also. They were known as the Salabogam. That land was known as the Salabogam. The famous college during the Pandya reign was the Kandalur Salai. For the famous college during the Pandya region, what is name? Kandalur Salai is the famous college. Okay. And Mutts also occupied the significant place in the promotion of the education. Education in the modern period. Modern period, how was the education? Modern period, the Ferandas who came to Madurai during the time of the Veerappa Naik established a primary schools. Sherfoji too also collected the old records and kept them in the Saraswati Mahal library, which is in the Tanjore. In Tanjore, Saraswati Mahal, the biggest library is there. Then in that largest library, Sherfoji too, what he did, he collected all the books, the Tamil literary books, everything, and kept in that place for the study purpose. Sir Thomas Munro, the governor of Madras Presidency, was highly responsible for the introduction of the Western education in Madras Presidency. And also he only appointed the committee for the educational purpose. And the education commission of Munro recommended the creation of two principal schools in each district. Two principal schools is started there. In 1835, Lord William Bentinck, he passed a resolution favoring the introduction of Western system of education in India. Wood's dispatch, this also already I told, in 1854, introduced in the Madras Presidency, which is called as the Magna Carta of India. The Madras University was founded in 1857. Madras University was founded in 1857. Still now it is there, isn't it? Madras University. In which year I told? In 1857 it was founded. And also the university in Tamil Nadu also, it was the first university in Tamil Nadu under the British rule. In 1882, the Local Boards Act was also passed. 1938, all subjects except English were taught in Tamil in schools. All the that means other subjects, means science, social, maths, everything, it taught in Tamil alone. Only in the English alone, they taught in the English itself. The Annamalai University, it was founded in 1929 in Sidambaram. This was the next step in the development of the higher education. Education since independence, actually free education only given in Tamil Nadu, that we know, isn't it? The secondary, up to the secondary level, actually it was introduced in 1964-65. The Gandhigram Rural College was established in 1975. From the 1971, the distance education system also introduced in Tamil Nadu. Okay, for what purpose? Those who can't be able to move for the college for the study purpose. And for that people alone, the distance education system, it was introduced in the 1971 to educate all the peoples in the university level. In 1956 itself, midday meal program, it was launched in all the schools. Okay, and it was extended as nutrition meal scheme in 1982 to avoid the dropout of the students. And in 1986, several changes have been taken place to meet the changing dynamics of the society. Still now, we are educating in Tamil Nadu, we are giving the good education. Only we are following the good education system in Tamil Nadu. Thank you, kids.